After talking about the button snap match lock, I think it's time to talk about another snap match lock system, the Japanese match lock system, and how it works. Japanese matchlock, it was a kind of very iconic firearm in the world, although it was not an original weapon in Japan. Once we see a picture or a collection about it, we can immediately call its Japanese name, teppo. We have clear knowing the history, and also I made two videos about the Japanese teppo before. So this video, we will focus more on firearm tech. But before understanding the mechanism inside, I think it is necessary to know the different types of the Japanese matchlock at first. Yes, in history, there is not only one kind of type of Japanese matchlock. After the Portuguese matchlock tech was introduced into Tanegashima, an island of Japan, was developing hundreds of years, especially in the Edo period. The matchlock might be in the most popular stage until the 19th century. More powerful Western firearms were introduced into Japan. Gradually, the native Japanese gun makers created the two different shapes of matchlock during the hundreds of years. The biggest difference is the position of the spring. One of both, the spring was fixed on the outside, and another kind of matchlock, the spring was on the inside. In Japanese language, both were called satobane and uchibane. For the outside spring version, in fact, this looked like the bottom snap matchlock, which might be the first gene of snap matchlock. As a newcomer of this family, the Japanese matchlock also preserved and continued some features of the bottom snap matchlock. Until now, we can see many shooting events where the people will wear the old-time clothes and shoot the very old matchlock, which usually is more than 100 years old or even older. Besides this, there are many other matchlocks in the museum. Among those Japanese matchlocks, the outside spring type may always be the most common type. The most noticeable point should be the large spring. Typically, when we see this kind of spring, we will know what type of Japanese matchlock it is. Then, the inside spring type, we can see there is a long spring fixed on the gun's body if it uses the inside spring type. So, this is also the most important feature for it, and the biggest difference with the outside spring type. Because of the turning power of the cock, it forms a spring, so it must be powerful enough even though it was moved to the inside. As we see, usually there is a smaller space on the inside of the gun. For the inside type, in order to use the most of the space effectively and meanwhile can offer enough power, the smart gunsmiths use the spiral spring, just like those built for pure mechanical watches. After talking about the spring, now it's time to move on to the mechanism parts of how they work cooperatively. To be honest, when I saw the Japanese matchlock a few years ago, at that time, I didn't even start to plan making this channel about the classical weapon. I found that this is likely too complex, even more complex than the common European matchlocks and the flintlocks, and it was very impressive in my mind. Usually, I finally made more and more studies in firearms. I certainly knew, actually, this was not hard to understand how it works. In fact, the key is about the turning direction of the trigger's lever. For example, the typical British or Spanish matchlock's lever was turned in a vertical direction, so it was easy to learn how it works. But for Japanese matchlock, the lever, which was turning in a horizontal direction, as a member of the traditional snap matchlock family, it continued using the similar trigger lever system from the button snap matchlock. They also used a trigger lever with horizontal turning direction. Not only the outside spring type, but the inside spring type. Both kinds of Japanese matchlock were based on this working logic. Okay, now, we have some pictures and photos with more details. let's analyze this device step by step. Overall, the Japanese matchlock can have typically two stages. In the first stage, pull the cork. The cork has a hook that can be locked by the inside trigger's lever. In addition, there is an inside flight spring on the trigger's lever, which can give enough power to the trigger's lever in order to lock the cork. In addition, it is worth mentioning that usually there is a small wrist part around the top of the inside trigger's lever. This can be identified as a rail in order to hook and lock the cork smoothly. Plus, for outside spring type Japanese matchlock, this small wrist part will be built on the outside. In contrast, for the inside spring type, this small part will be built on the inside. Meanwhile, the plate and this wrist part also can have the function of limiting the moving in order for the lever and the cork to move in the right range of position. Then, the next step, we can move on to the second stage. It is just fire. In this stage, we can only pull the trigger gently. The trigger will continue to pull the tail of the trigger's lever. And here is a small feature for the tail part of the trigger's lever, which is built and bent into a curved shape. Strictly speaking, this curve has obtuse angle. So when the trigger pulled, it will be able to push the curved tail back. And meanwhile, the tail will continue bringing the whole of trigger's lever, turning in a horizontal direction. And with it, the top of the trigger's lever will be withdrawn back into the inside of the gun's body. So at the same moment, the cork can be in the unlocked state. Finally, the cork can catch the slow match and touches the priming powder that is pre-stocked in the pan. So this is the mechanics of the typical Japanese matchlock musket. Overall, it is a leveraged trigger system because the button had become the real trigger. Maybe before the matchlock was introduced into Japan, it might not have had this new change. So the smart gunsmiths, maybe Japanese gun makers, or maybe the European gun makers, just added a lever in the inside of the gun. But this lever maybe was turning in a horizontal direction compared with most European matchlock muskets. This kind of lever system may look more special. Finally, it formed this kind of iconic matchlock system. Okay, this is today's video. Hope you can like this video. Have a good day. See you next time. Bye.